In 2014, an international group of scientists presented an overwhelming amount of research raising alarm about the destructive effects of neonicotinoids and other systemic pesticides on the natural world.
More than 70 or 75% of the waters of the world are contaminated naturally.
You will affect the plant life, you will affect the animal life.
They disturb the whole ecosystem.
And we are exposed by our food to neonics.
We should be concerned about this.
Even if there's a low risk, there can still be a high impact.
Undermining the global food chain on our planet, systemic and synthetic pesticides are the most dangerous chemicals applied in agriculture all over the world.
Bees can be considered as samplers of the whole environment. They go and harvest nectar as far as 12 kilometers. Research have shown that neonicotinoids can modify some structures in the brain of a bee, and this could result in the loss of capacity to go home after foraging activities. We cannot afford losing bees that are actually pollinating our crops.
When we talk about pollinators, it's not just bees. It's also other animals, other insects that also pollinate, and birds also pollinate flowers. So all these different levels of organization within nature are linked. It's just, we are talking, let's say, in 10, 20 years, we won't have anything to eat because there are no pollinators. Or we will have an ecosystem which is completely distorted, with no insectivores, with no predators. We don't know exactly the consequences of that, but it's going to be, we can predict it's going to be a disaster, because we know that when we remove the base of the pyramid, everything else will fall.
Unfortunately, the alarm raised had a limited effect. The Silent Spring, envisioned by Rachel Carson in 1962, is becoming reality. We are poisoning the world. 3.5% decline in bird populations per year in the Netherlands. 75% decrease in the biomass of insects in protected areas of Germany. Alarming contamination of surface waters, up to 100% of the samples in the USA. Synthetic pesticides are responsible for most of the damage. A worldwide study of honey found neonics in 75% of the samples.
We asked people to collect honey, to buy honey in different places in the world. And we analyzed about 200 of these samples. And the results were really stunning. Even in places where very few people live, these pesticides are pretty much everywhere.
At the same time, the annual worldwide use of neonicotinoids has still grown further over the past few years.
Now, what we know is in the last 10 years, we have seen an increase in the concentrations of these insecticides in all the waters of the world. The more the insecticides are applied, the more residues we will have, the further they will reach.
Neonicotinoids are derived from nicotine molecules, and it is stunning how the industry claims that these chemicals would have no effect on large mammals. Recent research demonstrated development of smaller reproductive organs in white-tailed deer related to the consumption of contaminated water in amounts such as found in the USA. So what about humans? Research shows that our daily food, such as fruits, vegetables, cereals, juices, tea, and honey, is contaminated with neonics and other synthetic pesticides. An apple can contain up to 1,000 times more of these chemicals as compared to amounts found in water. As we are continuously exposed, neonics accumulate in our bodies and are found in urine and hair samples worldwide.
From our research group, the idea came, well, why shouldn't we test ourselves? So we are doing this analysis of neonicotinoids in our hair and in our urine samples. Of the results that we have, only a single person had no detectable neonicotinoids, and two were actually had extremely high concentrations, really frightening.
Japanese scientists directly linked symptoms such as headache, nausea, and heartbeat disruptions to inhalation of neonicotinoids sprayed in the fields and consumption of contaminated tea.
The fact that the tea leaves and all the fruits containing the neonics is a problem.
They complain headache, general fatigue or shoulder stiffness. And every patient who stopped taking tea and fruits, they all recovered.
5 years ago, the neonics has not detected from the urine sample, but now there is high frequency detected from the urine. So it means that the exposure levels is become higher and higher every year.
But it doesn't stop there. Already in 2012, a Japanese study revealed destructive effects of neonicotinoid poisoning on the neurological development of unborn and just born rats in physiology similar to humans. Consumed through food and drink, these pesticides easily cross the placenta to reach the womb, affecting the development of the unborn babies. Urine of underweight human babies born after full pregnancy already contains neonicotinoid metabolites. This proves that neonicotinoids are poisoning humans throughout the whole cycle of life, starting even before birth.
We already know that they have effect on the liver, thyroid, testicles, they are carcinogen, and we know that, which is the most worrying, they have effect on the neural development.
Damage to the developing child's brain, autism, disruption of the hormonal system as a whole, have all been linked to neonics and other synthetic pesticides. There could be no safe intake dose, but total zero.
Entire populations are starting to be almost experimental animals to see whether there are any long-term effects. We've seen this many times before, unfortunately. We've seen it in DDT, where when the DDT was finally prohibited in the 1970s, it was only later that the human health effects became known. And it would be really good if we could avoid that happening with neonicotinoids.
So why are we still using these highly toxic chemicals, destroying ecosystems and biodiversity and affecting our children, incompatible with any definition of sustainable agriculture, and even favoring pest resistance? The answer is in the money. The global market for pesticides topped $57 billion in 2019.
We have given a blank check to these companies since two generations, producing pesticides, producing now GMOs and everything. And the products were not designed to save the world or to feed the world. The primary goal is of course, a profit-making machine.
Now, imagine if you had bought a product 15 years ago with advertised performance, which you then found was not performed. You found it also had a habit of going rather risky side effects. What would you do? You'd take it back.
Independent scientists raising questions about these toxic chemicals are being personally attacked, their research undermined. It is cynical how lobbyists and agencies who used to work for the tobacco industry are now employed by the chemical giants to enforce their toxic products onto the world.
The most refreshing smoke of all.
The multi-billion dollar agrochemical companies still claim that their products are only harmful to target pests, and that farmers will not be able to feed the world without their products. But research shows no substantial drop of yield in, for example, rice, soya, or corn products produced without these chemicals.
Our studies show that the prophylactic use of neonics is not needed. More than 90% is useless. You don't need to treat.
I worked 25 years in rice, and in rice, a lot of the insecticides the farmer use are completely unnecessary. But most farmers react to them when they see little worms eating parts of their leaf. They disturb the entire ecosystem and create new problems.
And there are proven alternatives, such as integrated pest management or ecological intensification and organic farming, making the use of synthetic pesticides totally unnecessary.
IPM means to find alternatives to chemicals. These solutions imply the rotation, physical treatment, they imply biological control agents application, and so on.
So change is possible to abolish these toxins from our lands and our food. In 2018, France was the only country in the world to ban the use of neonicotinoids on its land by law, followed by the small province of Marinduque, the butterfly island of the Philippines, resulting in stricter legislation and directives in other parts of the world.
Maybe it's high time for us to wake up. It's a long overdue. Let's protect our nature. Let's love our plants. Be a part of change.
So at this moment, there is such an initiative in Switzerland. I'm actually involved in this because I believe, again, that we could and we should try to do without these pesticides. It has to come from the people.
The research of the independent scientists of the Task Force on Synthetic Pesticides is very clear. Neonicotinoids and other synthetic pesticides are dangerous for public health. Precautionary and preventative measures should be firmly taken.
I think it's time to go to some alternatives to reduce drastically the use of neonics worldwide.
You know, 10-20% of agriculture is organic. It works. Why are we still hesitating? We should just go change.
For over 70 years, scientists have studied the impact of synthetic pesticides on the environment and public health. Their efforts to raise awareness have had only limited success. Politicians and legislators have largely failed to heed these warnings, allowing unprecedented destruction of the environment and public health. The people have the unique capacity to introduce a change in legislation. By taking responsibility where their leaders have failed, they can be the agents of this needed change.